So what is impetigo? Impetigo is a bacterial skin infection, and it is one of the most highly contagious skin infections, mainly affecting infants and children. It can occur in adults, but it is seen far more often in children. It usually appears as red sores on the face, especially around a child's nose and mouth, and on the feet and hands. The sores burst and develop an amber-colored crust, caused by one or two kinds of bacterial strep infection or staph infection. Often, these bacteria enter the body when the skin has already been irritated or injured because of other skin problems, such as eczema, poison ivy, insect bites, burns, or cuts. Children may get impetigo after they have had a cold or allergies that may have made the skin under the nose raw. But impetigo can also develop in completely healthy skin. So who is at risk for impetigo? Let's think about the factors that increase the risk of impetigo. And they include age. Remember, impetigo mostly commonly occurs in children ages 2 to 5. It's also much more increased with crowded conditions. Impetigo spreads easily in schools and childcare settings. It spreads more with warm, humid weather because the infections are more common in the summer. Certain sports also contribute to the spread of impetigo. Remember, participation in sports that involve skin-to-skin contact, such as football or wrestling, increases your risk of developing impetigo. And then lastly, broken skin. The bacteria that cause impetigo often enter your skin through small skin injuries, insect bites, or rash. How is impetigo transmitted? The main way is direct contact. Impetigo is spread mainly by person-to-person contact. It is rapidly spread through direct transmission in daycare centers and schools. Less frequently, the disease may be spread indirectly by contact with sheets, clothing, or toys contaminated by infected individuals. Impetigo is mainly confined to humans. Contact sports may spread impetigo. Wrestling is considered to be the most likely sport to spread it, followed by football and rugby. In talking about the period of communicability, if the disease is untreated, purulent discharges may remain infectious for weeks to months. Most cases are no longer infectious after 24 hours of appropriate antibiotic therapy. In looking at the incubation period, streptococcal infections range between 1 to 3 days. For staphylococcal infections, the range is between 4 to 10 days. Looking at the signs and symptoms, sores that begin as small red spots then change to blisters that eventually break open. The sores are typically not painful, but they may be itchy. Sores that ooze fluid and look crusty, sores that increase in size and number, and lastly, sores that may be as small as a pimple or larger than a coin. Let's take a look at the testing, diagnosis, and treatment of impetigo. Doctors usually diagnose impetigo by looking at the distinctive sores. Occasionally, a lab test is required, but are generally not necessary. In treating the impetigo, we usually use an antibiotic ointment. This ointment would be applied directly to the sores. You may need to first soak the affected area in warm water or use wet compresses to help remove the scabs so the antibiotic can penetrate the skin. If you have more than just a few impetigo sores, your doctor might recommend antibiotic drugs that can be taken by mouth. Be sure to finish the entire course of medication, even if the sores are healed. This helps prevent the infection from recurring and makes antibiotic resistance less likely. In prevention of impetigo, keeping skin clean is the best way to keep it healthy. It's important to wash cuts, scrapes, and insect bites and other wounds right away. To help prevent impetigo from spreading to others, gently wash the affected area with mild soap and running water and then cover lightly with gauze. Wash an infected person's clothes, linens, and towels every day and don't share them with anyone else in your family. Wear gloves when applying antibiotic ointment and wash your hands thoroughly afterward. Cut an infected child's nails short to prevent damage from scratching. Wash hands frequently and keep your child home until your doctor says he or she is no longer contagious.